वेलकम स्टूडेंट, वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल रिसर्च शॉर्ट वीडियो। टुडे वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द सिस्टमैटिक सैम्पलिंग। इफ यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट सिस्टमैटिक सैम्पलिंग, सो मेनी रिसर्चर एंड स्टूडेंट हैव कंफ्यूजन कि इट्स कम्स अंडर प्रोबेबिलिटी टेक्निक और नॉन प्रोबेबिलिटी टेक्निक। बट यस, इट्स कम्स अंडर नॉन प्रोबेबिलिटी मेथड। व्हाई इट्स कम्स अंडर नॉन प्रोबेबिलिटी मेथड, बट देर आर लिटिल बिट कन्फ्यूजन अबाउट कि इट्स कंसिडर एज ए why is considered a non probability, why we are not considering its a probability, because systematic word shows that if we are using the selection of sample through systematic way, so obviously in all probability sampling method we use systematic way. If you talk about the simple random sampling, if you talk about the proportionate sampling, if you talk about the area of cluster sampling, all probability sampling is systematic in manner. But yes, still systematic sampling is considered as a non-probability method. Why? Because systematic sampling include under one category of non-probability, because in this case we just select or drawing a number of individual from every n number of persons. Suppose we have a 60 student list, we just out of these 60 we constitute in a that manner, we just arrange in a particular list. And out of this list, we just call every fifth number of an individual. So this is the way generally we use in a systematic way. Whenever our social surveyor is going on a society, they just survey in a household survey, they just take every fifth number of house, every tenth number of house. So this is the process generally we use in a systematic manner. So in this such a plan, if you talk about the probability and non-probability technique, so if you have clear idea about what is probability and what is non-probability, so I think there is no confusion to understand the systematic sampling, why it comes under non-probability. Because in systematic sampling, we just skip all fourth individual in between 5th to 10th, or in between starting from 1st to 4th. So in this case, we are not given equal opportunity to comes under sample. So in this way, it's considered as the non-probability sampling. There is no the characteristic of randomness. So in this case, we are not giving an equal opportunity of every individual of our population to comes under our sample. So that's why systematic sampling is considered as a non-probability sampling, and otherwise other things is called probability sampling. If we talk about advantage and disadvantage, systematic sampling is a relatively a quick method. Social surveyor most of the time quickly use this method to select the household and the survey, and systematic sampling it makes very easy to check every nth number of the name to be selected. So it's very simple, and systematic sampling ignore all the person between the every end element. So this is the advantage, that's why it's considered as a non-probability sampling. In systematic sampling, sampling error increase. Obviously the list arrange, suppose if we list arrange our list in a particular manner, suppose on the basis of age, on the basis of other criteria, so there is a chance that there is sampling error. So there are few there is one article that is using the systematic sampling. So if you are interested, you can go and see the perceived benefit and risk of social media. Ethiopian secondary school student, in this research they use the systematic sampling. So if you are interested, you just go and click on that link, or you find this article easily available. Full article is available for you. And thank you so much for watching my video. If you are interested to visit my social profiles, so these are the links for my social profiles. If you like video, please share it, or please subscribe my channel, or share your idea and thoughts in a comment box. Thank you so much for watching this video.